bacon, rotten eggs, and gunpowder. That's what outer space smells like, according to those who have been there. But how can the near vacuum of space smell like anything? Stick around and I'll let you in on the stanky secrets of the cosmos. Hey everyone, Matt here. When it comes to space smells, it's all about location, location, location. While most of space is a cold, dark void, there are spots where it's anything but. Take, for instance, the cloud of gas and dust surrounding a comet's core. Last fall, the European Space Agency's Rosetta mission got its first whiff of the cloud enveloping comet 67P CG, which I think is named after a lesser-known android in the Star Wars universe. Anyhow, mass spectrometers aboard the Rosetta orbiter sniffed out some odorless gas molecules, like water vapor, methane, and carbon monoxide. But as researchers examined Rosetta's data, they detected much more pungent chemicals in the comet's perfume too. That's according to Katrine Altweg, one of the Rosetta mission's principal researchers. Beyond the odorless chemicals in the comet's blasé bouquet, the comet was also releasing ammonia, formaldehyde, and some famously fragrant sulfur compounds. One of these compounds, hydrogen sulfide, accounts for that rotten egg smell I mentioned earlier. The European Space Agency sums it up best saying, "If you could smell the comet, you would probably wish that you hadn't, smiley face." Leaving 67P and heading closer to Earth, different odors start popping up. Astronauts from the International Space Station have reported catching whiffs of meaty aromas, like bacon, after getting back into the ISS after spacewalks. And if you believe NASA's early moonwalkers, our moon doesn't actually smell like cheese. Its scent is more like gunpowder. Some attribute this parfum explosif to chemical reactions that take place inside the space capsule once astronauts get back from their lunar jaunts. The moon's surface is coated with dust particles with lots of dangling bonds. These are uncoupled reaction sites with some extra electron love to share, just waiting for a partner. These bonds would react quickly with molecules in the Earth's thick atmosphere, but they persist unbound in the moon's sparse exosphere. So when these compounds mingle with the oxygen inside a lunar lander, they go ballistic, at least in the olfactory sense of the word. As Apollo 17 astronaut Gene Cernan put it, "Smells like someone just fired a carbine in here." That's all for this Speaking of Chemistry. Be sure to check out the fantastic article by Elizabeth Wilson that inspired this episode. It also explains this whole incredible thing. And while you're at it, why not learn about the delectable science behind bacon's enchanting aroma from our good friends at ACS Reactions. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and share.